Hi guys, Adam here. So welcome to this stormy morning. There's a lot of wind today, so welcome back after 3 months. So I'll be showing today what happened to my prototype of the SIM808 tracker, which is not right now almost completed and can be used in commercial. So as you can see, first of all, I have changed my GPS antenna to something bigger, which gives more accuracy, and also added some crystal inside to have a stable clock frequency. But today I will show you something that I didn't last time, so I'll be showing what's the communication between the module and the MCU itself, and that will be done using the PuTTY terminal on Windows machine, which I have here. So I have brand new laptop and quite old Samsung that I will be using. I have two USB to serial converters, FTDI based, one on the left side, second on the right side, and these two are connected over simple cabling to my board exactly here, so you can see that I'm not trying to fool you. Also remember this capacitor that should be added to ensure the stability of this Chinese board, and this all is powered from the simple USB power bank. Okay, so hopefully all will work fine and I'll be able to show you how it really works. So right now I'm switching to my laptop and I'll be recording second part of this video from the laptop. Bye bye. Hello again guys, so I'm right behind my laptop and trying to show you something with the GPS tracker based on SIM808. So right now I have a control panel, and remember those two serial converters that I showed just before, they are attached to serial, virtual serial comms, COM number 4 and COM number 5, and now I'm launching PuTTY terminals to connect to the SIM808 and Atmega MCU. So first terminal will be operating on COM 4. Hold on, I'll just try to resize the window as the first communication window. Oh no, I like these windows a lot. Okay, that's the first part. And now the second PuTTY. Second PuTTY. So first terminal will show you what Atmega sends, and second what exactly this Chinese SIM808 port is sending. So hold on a minute, so I'll just try to resize it. So it would be visible. Right, so we have two communication windows, maybe not exactly like I wanted, but yeah. Okay, so everything is connected. I have two FTDIs connected. One is connected to LXD, so receiving. Second is connected to transmitting pin, and now I'm switching the device on. Hold on. Now 5 volts is applied, and let's look. Okay, on the left side we have SIM808, which is trying to connect to the network, so it's already connected to the 2G networks. On the right side you can see the Atmega. Atmega is now turning off the echo, trying to fix the serial speed to 9600, and also trying if the pin on the SIM card is valid. And first it deletes all SMSs from the SIM, just to keep this one empty, not to interfere with other procedures. Okay, now it's registered, and now it waits something like, I believe, 45 seconds. Let's check the code. what do we have here? Yeah, it deletes and then it waits 45 seconds until the device registers in the 2G network. Okay. After that, it will try to provision some settings like CLIP, and we'll try to set up the board to notify of any incoming SMSs. It will turn off the GPS power just to prevent from draining battery, and now it goes into the sleep mode. So when you look into the code, it goes directly like this. So it will enable text mode for the SMSs, then it will turn on the sleep mode and switch off the GPS. Okay, now it is in a stage that is waiting for some kind of trigger, like SMS or the voice call. So if you intend to use voice call, you first have to send command named activate. So I will do it right now. So let's check how it will operate then. Okay, I'm calling it from the mobile phone right now. So let's start. Okay, under voltage warning, yes. Okay, so as you can see that the power source needs to be strong enough, needs to give these 2 amps to make the SIM808 board work flawless. Otherwise you will get such kind of under voltage warning. But anyway, the command was accepted, and you can see that the board itself and the MCU started the GPS positioning procedure. As you can see, it's querying for the GPS status, and as soon as it will get the valid status, so that would be visible on the left side, I will get the text message with the GPS location. So, hold on, the wind is strong, so hopefully it will not break my device nearby. So depending on the coverage and on the antenna, it will take at least 1 to 4 minutes. If it does not succeed, then the device and the code will go to the alternative way, which is basically calling the GPS servers, querying GPS servers with the initial data, which is a base station ID and the Google. Okay, we can see that location is already fixed, at least two dimensional. Okay, so we'll wait for the 3G and we'll wait for the okay, so 2G is okay, but there's no 3D yet, so two dimensional it may be sufficient, but the 3D is this is what we want. Okay, so we got the location, and it is now sending, yeah, it's sending the location to my mobile phone. So, yeah. Yeah, I got the message with the location. Okay, now it's clearing everything, it's going back to the waiting mode. Basically it's going back to this portion of code right here. So we are waiting for the anything on the serial port or the voice call. So basically the code itself is optimized to use text messages. There are 4 text commands. One is activate to store your phone number. That would be validated when the voice call is made to the device. The second thing is a command single, which gives a single GPS tracking position. And there's a command multi, which will give you five measurements, concurrent measurements in 3 to 4 minutes interval. And the last command, I think that's the last but not least, I will give something in the future, is the command named guard. The guard means that it will guard your vehicle. So if you send guard to the device, it will constantly be checking the GPS position, and if there's something wrong, within 1 minute, if the position changes like 300 meters or 1000 feet, then you'll get a text message that your vehicle was stolen and you need to do something. So as you can see, when there's a voice call made, we're checking EPROM, which stores the phone number. Okay, let's check how the SMS text messages work right here. So I will now send the command single to this device. Okay, let's set single. Okay, now it's okay. As you can see on the left side, the SIM808 reported that there was an incoming text message with the content single. So the right side shows what exactly the MCU is doing. It will reply with the communication that the single measurement has started and you need to wait for the outcome. Right now it still launches the GPS power and makes a cold reset to the GPS, and in a minute it will try to retrieve the GPS position. So hold on. Just as before, on the left side you can see what the SIM808 is sending to the Atmega, and on the right side you can see the back communication. So Atmega is sending CGPS status command to query the location and to check if the location is fixed. On the left side you can see the output of SIM808. So as before, it will take up to 3 to 4 minutes, so hold on. When you look into the code, you can see that this part of code exactly is doing this way. Okay, so when we have incoming SMSs, the buffer is checked against the predefined program memory cut coded lines. So if the command is multi or single, you will have single. So first it switches off the sleep mode, then it sends acknowledge on SMS. And important thing is that I am using some kind of variables here to indicate which kind of mode is currently ongoing. So the important part, I think, that made me a lot of problems was the how to calculate the GPS position properly. Oh, yeah, I already got the message at C. Yeah, message was sent with my location. Oh, sorry guys, I missed something. Yeah, but you can see that it already sent location. So after checking like something like this command CGPS status, it's being sent every 15 seconds. So it took almost less than 2 minutes to hold the location with such huge GPS antenna. Okay, what I was saying is that the hardest part for the code was maybe it is it's a bit funny, but the problem was that the SIM808 bot, it has a different GPS format that the Google servers are using. So I need to make some computation, I need to make some calculation to encode the Google position properly. So this is being done by this part of code, which is, looks somehow different, somehow strange, but it really does the job. Okay, maybe we'll enable something like guard mode, just to show you which is the most important feature of this device. So the guard is the command that will really help you. It will basically notify you if there's something wrong with the position, if the position has changed, if the vehicle moved. So that may be the useful command of that call. Yeah, I will now send the guard option. Let's send the guard. Yeah, I'm sending guard, so you will be seeing it on the left side. Just one second. Guard. So the guard will be confirmed. Guard mode activated. So please wait 5 minutes. So it is a simple precaution because basically it will. You will need at least 1 minute. So after 1 minute, the position will be checked. Okay, as you can see on the right side, is enabling GPS once again and make a cold restart and querying the GPS status. So in a while, the location will be actually correct, and then it will try to compare the location, the next location, with the previous one. So it will compare location every single minute. And if there's something wrong, if the location is different for something like 300 of the last positions, then you'll be notified with the text message that your vehicle was stolen. But I don't think I can arrange this kind of scenario for you because I'm on my balcony, so yeah, I'm not able to move something like 300 meters, so forgive me that. But as you can see, so it is querying once on the right side, and then it waits 1 minute, but while waiting, it is actually waiting for the stop message. Okay, so we can see that the GPS is actually working pretty well because it's right now giving some location. Okay, if you want to stop this mode, simply set a stop message to this device. Okay, I'm doing it right now. Stop. To quit this guard mode. Okay, so the device said that guard mode has stopped and is waiting for other commands. I'll be developing this code further, so keep an eye on my GitHub page, and if you have some ideas, simply tell me in the comments, and of course give the thumb up, so I'll be doing some other interesting projects. Bye bye. Subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe.